Hey guys, it's Emily and welcome back to my YouTube channel. It has been quite a while since I have last posted and I apologize to all my subscribers for that. There has been a lot going on since I last posted a video and I can't wait to share that with you guys. I know that right now we're all in the middle of coronavirus. We're all in the middle of quarantine. I don't know what state you're in. I don't know what, you know, orders have been given, but currently right now in the state where I live, we are still under quarantine and I am working from home. That is a part of the reason why I haven't been uploading videos on YouTube. From the last video I posted, there was just so much that had been going on, not only outside of my personal life, but also in my personal life, good things in my personal life that hopefully I get to share with you guys in the near future. But for right now, I do apologize to everyone that I have not been posting, but I'm here now and I have had some time to finally get myself together, get my ideas together, and just really give out a message to everyone right now in the middle of this crisis, in the middle of what is going on in our nation. And I really, really want to share with you guys the message that the Lord has given me for you guys. So without further ado, let's get started with this video. So as we all know, at this very moment, a lot of us are still under quarantine. A lot of us are working from home. A lot of us are currently not working. A lot of us are at home, sitting down, chilling, catching up on some Netflix movies, just binge eating, binge watching, and doing all sorts of stuff. But if you're the other kind of person that is just working out, working at it, and trying to keep your schedule good for you, it has been very difficult for me ever since I started working from home. But one of the greatest things that has helped me throughout this quarantine is growing a deeper relationship with Jesus. And why do I say that? Because it is so important that this time that we have now is a great opportunity not only to grow a better relationship with your family, your children, your husband, your wife, or your friends, but also with Jesus. And that's the very, very most important thing. And I want to share with you guys, what are some ways we can grow a better relationship with God, especially during this time? I have four different ways we can grow a closer relationship with the Lord. And one of the ways that we can do that is by, of course, praying. The Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians 5:17 to pray without ceasing. Prayer, as I've said before, is such a great way to communicate with the Lord. It's the way we communicate with the Lord, by expressing our feelings verbally to God and just telling him how we feel, letting our burdens to the Lord. And that is super, super important in a Christian's life to pray. The second thing I want to share with you guys is read the Bible, reading God's word. Matthew 4:4 says, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God." While we are feeding ourselves physically during this time, also feed yourself spiritually, because our soul needs it. I was telling girls for my small group that it is super important that during this time, we feed our souls. We feed our souls with the word of God, because it's super important. And I have been doing that these past few weeks and it has been amazing. It has been so good, because through God's word, he gives us strength. And so it's very important to read the word of God. And the third thing I would very definitely say it's super important to grow a relationship with the Lord is by fasting. There's different ways that a lot of people fast. They do a social media fast where you get off social media for a week or a month or probably 2 months, whatever the Lord puts in your heart. There's also fasting that we don't eat or drink nothing for a whole day. Or there's also intermediate fasting, fasting with only fruits and vegetables and leaving meat out of the picture. But fasting is also very important for our souls so that we get to grow closer to the Lord. And Jesus sets that example for us when he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. Now, doesn't have to be that extreme where we have to fast 40 days and 40 nights. If you can do it, that's amazing and that's awesome. But for beginners, you can fast a day, half the day. But fasting is such a good and important part of a Christian's life. So that is another way we can grow a closer relationship to Christ. For the fourth thing, I would definitely say, stay within your church community. It is super, super important for a Christian, for somebody who is trying to grow a relationship with Christ, to stay within their Christian community. I know it is very difficult at the moment because we're not allowed to gather in groups of 10 or more, or even maybe we're just, or wherever you are, you're just not allowed to gather at all. But pretty sure there are resources out there to continue to be within that community, whether that is over FaceTime, over a Zoom call, over a telephone call, or a text. Just stay within your community. Don't ever forget that people out there love you and that Christ is still in the means, and there's people out there that would love to pray for you. So continue to stay within your community. Continue to surround yourself with those people. Call up a friend, anything, whoever like the Lord puts in your heart. Continue to be surrounded by those people because it is super important. Continue to check on each other because it's super important that as a church, as a person who believes in Christ, that we are still sticking together during this time. So I definitely recommend that. And those would be four things that I definitely recommend during this quarantine, that we get closer to the Lord. Yes, we need to feed ourselves. Yes, we need time to like de-stress and probably go out for a walk or paint or listen to music, whatever it is that you do. But also we have to be accountable for our soul, because that is the most important thing within our life. At the end of this life, what all that matters is our soul, because that's what God will be receiving at the end. It's our soul. And so that's what we need to continue to feed our souls. I would also recommend, this probably be number five, to read a book that feeds you the word of God. Definitely. I am the type of person that reads books that is Christian based, life based. It's awesome that a lot of other people read different kinds of book, but definitely read a book where your spirit is filled with the good news of Jesus or somebody's testimony. I really, really recommend that. It's just a great way to grow your relationship with the Lord and just see how God works in other people's lives through so many different authors. Also, I think tip number five is definitely listen to some worship. Worship in your home. Like, you don't need to be in a church where you're the choir is singing or the band is playing or the worship team is singing. I believe with all my heart that you can be at home if you know your instrument, if you know how to play the guitar, the piano, whatever it is, or if you want to put some karaoke on for a worship song, or if you just want to sing a cappella with no music, I definitely recommend to worship the Lord at any given moment that you have time. Just sing your lungs out. Nobody's listening to you at this time. You know, go into your room, go into your bathroom, wherever it is, you know, where you could get out from, you know, from being around your friends or your family. Definitely get out and just sing your lungs out to Jesus. I have done that a couple of times and it has been great. So I definitely would recommend that. But if you don't want to do that, you should also just sit in your room, sit wherever you're at, listen to some worship songs and listen to the lyrics. I know that that's another way that the Lord speaks to me, is just by worship and recognizing how amazing He is and how His mercy and love is just so, so great. So that would be that would be like my fifth thing that I would tell you guys, that it would be great for you to grow that relationship with Christ. So the first thing is pray without ceasing, read the word of God, fasting, read a good book that could help you, you know, grow closer to the Lord. And number five is just by worshiping. And these are five things that have actually been helping me during this quarantine. Outside of that, yes, I have been hanging out a lot with my sister, my cousins. I have been doing my small groups. I've gone to see a friend and we've painted, we've eaten together. That is great and that is awesome. But please, please do not forget to feed your soul with some Jesus. This is a great, great time for us to do that. I feel like God has given us the opportunity right now to do that and to recognize that He is God above all things. And while this is happening in our nation and throughout the whole world, I can still claim that God is sovereign and God is so good. And He has given me the strength to say that. I know that this has also affected so many people. And I just want to tell you that the Word of God also says that all things work together for the good of those who love them. I know this has taken a toll on so many people. I know that this might have affected you and your family, and I am praying for you guys. But I also want to tell you that God during this time is still good and is watching over you, and He loves you so, so much. And I definitely recommend that during this time, if you haven't already, definitely get to know who God is. I am here. If you guys also want to talk, my social medias are in the description below, and I am here if you guys want to talk. But I'm praying for each and every one of you, and I love you guys. So guys, this is the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I enjoyed filming it for you guys. I'm so happy to be back. Everything is coming together, so I'm so happy to be back. But I hope this is a reminder for you guys as well to not only physically feed your body or grow a closer relationship with your loved ones, but also grow a relationship with the Lord, because He loves you, and feed your heart and your soul with God's word. So I love you guys so, so much. I will see you guys very, very soon. Love and blessings always. Bye.